Right, what's up, family? You're back with another episode of Gods and Goddesses Weather Report Tarot Readings. It's your girl, Janether, and today we're going to get into the energy of the Divine Masculine, the Divine Feminine, and the Karmic. So we're going to get into all of the energies, y'all. That's what we're doing today. So, before I read to you the channel message that I got, let's go to the song that I got during the channel message. I got this message through water running, and it popped this song in my head, Boys to Men, Water Runs Dry. So check it out, I'm gonna do the first verse of it. Pass the dance of the dam.
We don't even talk anymore, and we don't even know what we argue about. Don't even say I love you no more. Saying how we feel is no longer allowed. Some people work things out, and some just don't know how to change. Let's go wait till the water runs dry. We might watch our whole lives pass us by. Let's go wait till the water runs dry. Torn apart. Why do we hurt each other? Why do we push love away? Let's go wait till the water is
dry. No,
we might watch our whole lives pass us by.
We might let it all.
Let's go wait till the water is dry.
So let's get into the reading. Basically, with that song message, I hope you guys could hear it clearly. With the song message, it's basically, I feel like that could be what the DM is saying or feeling towards the DF, like, or the DF. I feel like this is the mutual feelings between a DM and a DF. Like, let's not let our lives pass us by. We can both feel what's going on. But then there were certain messages that are in that song. Go back and listen to it, where you're going to hear where it kind of sounds like the karmic situation as well, where they're saying, we don't even talk anymore. We don't even know what we argue about. Can't even say I love you no more. Saying how we feels is no longer allowed. Some people work things out, and some just don't know how to change. Let's go into the water and try. We might watch our whole lives pass us by. Let's go into the water and try. We'll make the biggest mistake of our lives. Don't do it, baby. So, I feel like with both of those, that's relevant to both messages. And that's, I want to say the first verse, maybe. I don't know. It could be the second verse of that song. I'm not sure. Beautiful song. I love Boys to Men. I am a fanatic. I like them. Alright, so, before we get into any cards, I'm going to also tell you what I got from the channel messages. I heard, this is weird, this is a milestone for me spiritually, because I'm clear audience, but not in this way. Like, I'm more inner speech. I can hear, like, my mind will give me messages from the divine. And I can tell when they're coming to me from me or the divine, if it's something that I would have never thought of, had no clue to, or it's just a random-ass thought out of nowhere. That's how I know it's a divine message. But like I said, it's thoughts. So that's how I dissect those. But this message was my first actual, I don't know, like, super clear audience message, because I literally heard these beeps, like, loud as fuck in my ear, but it was basically where the beep sounded like it was coming from was, like, inside of my ear, but not all the way in. So basically, like, if you was to put your finger, like, half an inch into your ear, right there. So not all the way in the eardrum, but not all the way outside of the ear. It was actually in the closing part. So that's where the beep was, and it was four of them. It also seemed like a FBI type of beep, like a walkie-talkie type of beep. It didn't sound like, it was like a notification, but it sounded like something that an FBI member would do. That's what it was. Or Morse code type shit, you feel me? So also, I believe that signifies that everyone, because when I was channeling the energy, I pretty much had three figures up to represent each person: Divine Feminine, Divine Masculine, and the Karmic. So I feel like this represents that everyone in the situation is getting some sort of messages surrounding this or about this situation. When the water ran outside of me getting the download and the idea for the song, I also got, you know, of course the meaning of water means emotions. So I feel like a lot of emotions are being poured out. A lot of things from the past are being discussed or at least mulled over individually by each person, like really digging deep and going deep on things individually. I feel like this is more so a DM and karmic thing. I don't think the DF is going through really any of this. Even a lot of tears and feelings that run deep. So there could be a lot of crying being done with this karmic relationship. And a lot of emotions being poured out either individually or them doing this together, speaking to each other. The energy felt semi-thick while I was in meditation, but relaxing at the same time. And more so relaxing than thick. Like, usually when I'm in some nasty energy, some super thick, like, I'll literally get sick. Like, my stomach will hurt. I'll get dizzy. I'll have to come out of meditation and probably take a break for, like, a half hour before I can even do the reading. You know what I mean? So that's when I know I'm in some nasty, negative shit. Or just something where it don't even have to be that nasty, like, where it's some horrible shit. But it could just be low vibes. So someone just vibing so low and maybe getting defeated in life. It could be something like that. Someone who's just down and out, and I tap into their energy, and that's how I feel. But it fucks with me. But this didn't feel so thick. This felt, it felt semi-thick, but as that, it's basically that feeling of thickness began to dissipate as I got deeper into the reading, and it wasn't even super thick, but it definitely dissipated. So I feel like that's the energy right now in the situation. Like, everyone's pretty calm, but there is something in the air. That's what it seemed like. Like, there's a something in the air. I also feel like both energies do exist. Both the thick energy and both the relaxing energy exist. But the relaxing energy is overcoming any negative energy right now, which is a great thing. All right. So let's get into it. Let's see what cards come out. This is just the overall energy of the situation. Well, let's get the overall energy of the DM. That's what we're doing. A DM check-in, right? Overall energy of the DM. Alright, the overall energy of the DM, we got the counselor card. You are a natural counselor, and many people benefit from your guidance and reassurance. So the DM, Divine Masculine, could be out there really counseling or thinking about counseling. The DM could be a counselor, some type of, as far as their field of work. Or if they're not, they're just that person. They're the person that counsels people and assists them when they're in need. Very similar to what the DF does. So, you know, spread your wings. Do not hold back right now. The timing is perfect. And you are ready to soar. Oh, shit. So, the Divine Masculine is spreading their wings. Not holding back. They feel like the time is ready. Or time is now. And they're ready to soar. That's what this is saying. I haven't used this deck in a long time, guys. Gentleness. Archangel Sandalphon. Be very gentle with yourself at this time. Surround yourself with gentle people, situations, and environments. So as they're spreading their wings, they're surrounding themselves around gentle people, places, and environments. This would also be something for you to look at, because we know, Divine Feminine, you have stepped into your power in the past and have made it known what you wanted to a certain extent. I don't know, for everyone, you did this differently. I don't know how you guys did it. But right now, they are surrounding themselves around gentle people because they're in that energy. So for those of you who do want to have, I don't know, even conversation with your Divine Masculine, you're going to want to be in the energy of gentleness. Hello from heaven, Archangel Azrael. Your loved ones in heaven are doing fine. Let go of worries and feel their loving blessings. So, this is for you guys too, but for their energy, they may have been worried. Maybe someone just passed on in their family, and they're worried about them. So, this is a message for you, Divine Masculine, to let you know that your loved ones in heaven are doing fine, and they want you to be well, and, you know, stop worrying about them. They're doing just fine. Anything else from Divine Masculine? Anything else for Divine Masculine's energy? Anything else for Divine Masculine's energy? Hmm? You're thinking that long-term commitment, I don't know, though. Passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. Passion. Allow your heart and soul to sing with joy. So they're feeling passionate right now. Children. Your love life is being affected by children. They could be feeling very passionate about their relationship with their children. And allowing that to let their, soul sing with joy, them being with their children, which is always a great thing. Calling in your soulmate. Your prayers, affirmations, and visualizations help bring you together. So they're also in the energy of calling you in, Divine Feminine. Soulmate comes out again. Yes, this is your soulmate. So they know that you're the soulmate and they're calling you in. Leave comments, guys. Leave comments. Like and subscribe. This is a general reading, so all the messages can't resonate with everyone. You're going to have to take the messages that do resonate and leave the messages behind that do not resonate. Thank you very much. Retreat. It is time to disconnect from the world. So they could be wanting to go on some type of retreat with you, or this is just them really disconnecting from the world and retreating. Anything else from Divine Masculine? Alright, so let's get into these questions, guys. Let's see what's going on. This is going to give us the super skinny. We're going to see what the DM's energy is towards you in the tarot. No, we pretty much got it. The energy for the DM towards you is he realizes you're his soulmate. He also realizes that, he knows you're a soulmate, and he's very passionate about it. I feel like he's retreating, but yeah, we will pull more cards. He is retreating, and I feel like he's really taking out time for himself right now. Give me 5 cards for the deal. Queen of Swords. Three of Coins. 3 more cards. Alright, we got the Wheel of Fortune that came out. Judgment. And 4 of Staffs. So this is the energy. That's why the tarot, man. The tarot breaks it down. Even though the oracle cards are so direct with their messages, tarot really has a way of really fucking telling the story, y'all. So the overall energy of the Divine Masculine is the 4 of Staffs. This is the Twin Flame card. We're doing a Twin Flame reading, and the Twin Flame card comes out in the overall energy. This card, I see my Lover's card a lot as that too. But your Divine Masculine is in the energy of speaking their truth and standing firm on what they believe to be is true. So speaking their truth and standing firm on that truth. Why do I say that? Because I see them with their sword down, not really willing to budge from this position. And they're standing on a sturdy, stable slab of concrete. You feel me? Also, I see that they're definitely wanting to put work in on this stable relationship that they feel like they can have with their Divine Feminine. This card's right next, or diagonal to, and touching that 4 of Staffs card. So this is what's really on their mind, is how they can put in more work on this situation, because a judgment call has been made that really, the judgment is that you are the one. So remember I was talking about these messages that everyone's been receiving? Well, the messages that the Divine Masculine has really been receiving and honed in on are the messages that tell him, you're the Divine Feminine, you are his other half, you are the one that he's supposed to come into union with. So this has caused for the end of an old cycle and the beginning of a new cycle to begin, to start. Pretty, pretty dope shit. Alright. So let's see what's going on with the Karmic. It's the Karmic's energy. So the Karmic's overall energy is the 5 of Cups, disappointed in what has gone down, feeling like they've taken a loss. But there is something that they can gain from this, but they have not looked up to see what that is. And I believe that's what their divine messages are about, trying to let them know to go deeper and understand why this is happening, what's the meaning of this, and what they can do to actually play the alchemist in the situation. So you may, even if you did lose, Karmic, you may have lost, but there's still something. There's always something to be gained. So you may have lost the relationship and gained wisdom about how to be better in your next relationship, or gained wisdom on something. What, or was it truly all for nothing? So that's the main thing that the messages are, or the messages that are coming in for the Karmic, is to ensure that this is not for nothing. You learn what you need to learn so you can move on to your next cycle in life, your next lessons. So, but they're looking down and feeling the hurt and the loss of this. Also, the Karmic is still trying to be in power as the King of Staffs. Either that, or this is the Divine Okay, I think I see what this is. This is the divine masculine in the power of, as the king of staffs, turned with their back turned. So the king of staffs has their back turned to this person. And this person's upset, sad, but you see these divine messages are coming in. And this person has their back turned. It looks like they're in deep thought, trying to think of what's next. It looks like they're looking out into the distance, trying to see where they're going next. And if you notice, they also have a messenger in the form of a dung beetle, a messenger of God that's giving them messages. So, also, the karmic, I feel like, is feeling attacked right now. Because I do go by color coordination a lot. So I feel like the karmic has confusing energy right now. It's like these are all the energies of the karmic. Sad, feeling attacked, feeling like the peasant or the beggar, or like they just don't have enough. So they're kind of playing that please don't go type of role. And then also, I feel like also trying to act like they're a hard worker at the same time. Like, I don't know. It's confusing. It's confusing. But I know for sure they're trying to have strength. And they're also trying to work on this. They don't want this situation with the Divine Masculine to be completely over. Give me more on the karmic. Clarify that Eight of Coins. No, clarify the King of Staffs. Yeah, okay. Yeah, they're definitely upset. I clarified the King of Staffs and the Queen of Staffs came out. The counterpart and the emotional fulfillment card. So they're upset because they know this king has gone off to be with their queen and find this emotional fulfillment. Clarify that Knight of Swords. Clarify that Knight of Swords. Yeah, so they want to fight. They want to actually stop this person from going, but I don't believe they have the strength to do so. Too many cards came out. I don't believe they have the strength to do so. They would love to. Maybe they are putting up a fight, but they feel like they're too weak to win the fight. Yeah, so they're really, the Four Swords came out. This is rest, healing. They're in hermit mode, reflecting on what the hell's going on or what caused them to get in this situation to where now they're the ones, the karmic, and y'all who's been following the twin flame journey know this is a quite a catch-22 for the karmic to be in this energy, stuck and confused. This is where the divine feminine was before she bossed up and started moving on and started realizing that it's really about self-love and taking care of yourself. And then things just kind of started automatically rolling. But this is where the Divine Feminine was. So it's almost like the karmic is now starting at square one of their journey. Because remember, the karmic gets someone as well. But they don't get anyone if they stay. They don't get anyone of quality if they stay in karmic energy. If they can overcome, then they will eventually get out of these energies and actually be able to have something successful with someone. Okay. So, let's see what the DM's next move is towards you. Or what does the DM want to tell you? What does Divine Masculine want to tell you? We're going to use Oracle cards for this. What does Divine Masculine want to tell Divine Feminine? What does Divine Masculine want to tell Divine Feminine? I'm so close to reaching out to you. What else does Divine Masculine want to tell Divine Feminine? Black magic karmic. So they may want to speak to you about some of the illusions that the karmic had them under. What else is Divine Masculine going to tell you? They are my karmic. So, yeah, they definitely want to tell you about the things that the karmic has done to them and how they... I think these things that they've done to them, it's going to be like telling you the story to let you know how they came to find out that this person was actually their karmic partner. Live your best life. So they do want you to live your best life as always. That comes out a lot when I pull from this deck for them. What else do they want to... Power couple. That's been coming out like crazy. You are so strong and motivate me daily. So... Your Divine Masculine is watching you somehow. You know, we have many ways, social media, whatever it is. Some of you guys are in contact with your Divine Masculine. And you're, you know, you're motivating them daily. Maybe you're the one who's making them or inspiring them to do the counseling and really have the strength to leave the karmic situation. Our love enlightens me. This is just further stating the truth behind that. You're definitely, you're motivating this person. Marriage, union. And they want to tell you that they want a marriage, they want to come into union with you. They're tired of being apart, they're tired of being separated, so they're purging and releasing what no longer serves them. I set myself free. Breakup. And you are not alone. You're not alone. Earth. This reminds me of even the Earth song, but Earth, you're not alone. So basically your advice, though, too, is to let it flow. Don't do anything, Divine Feminine. Everything is actually going as planned. Everything's flowing as it should be. So you don't have to do anything right now, Divine Feminine, but keep being Divine Feminine. That's all you have to do. So we'll do probably, I think I'm going to do just a karmic update next. And we're going to really get into like what the karmic was hiding, what their intentions were, what they did to wreck the union in the first place. And that's just a recap. I think things are starting to simmer down where we can kind of do things like that. But we'll see. We'll see. I'm pretty sure that's going to be the next reading. But we'll see if things are simmering down or not. But I thank you guys for tuning in. This has been another episode of Gods and Goddesses Weather Report Tarot Readings. It's your girl, Jen Ether. Please like and subscribe to the channel. I appreciate you. All right, I'm out. Peace.